Former Philippine National Police Chief Camilo Cascolan has been appointed as an Undersecretary of the Department of Health. Cascolan took over the position of Roger Bongan. Prior to his appointment at the DOH, Cascolan was appointed as Undersecretary at the Office of the President in February 2021. He served as PNP Chief from September to November 2020. Cascolan was among those who authored OPLAN Double Barrel, which became the police's flagship program in the war against illegal drugs. The controversial OPLAN Boktang, which is linked to thousands of deaths of drug suspects, was implemented under this program. Now, in a statement, the Alliance of Health Workers denounced Cascolan's appointment, calling it a huge insult to health experts who are more qualified for the post. The group expressed concern about Cascolan's human rights record, saying they preferred an undersecretary who is an expert on infectious diseases, not in supposed extrajudicial killings. The group also reiterated its call for President Ferdinand Marcos to appoint a health chief. The Philippines is back to normal and ready to receive tourists. That's according to President Marcos, who attended Sunday's Mascara Festival in Bacolod City. Marcos said he would use Bacolod as an example to prove the country is back on its feet after bearing the brunt of the pandemic. Bacolod's Mascara Festival returned Sunday after a two-year hiatus due to the pandemic.
Pinakita ninyo dito sa pag-celebrate ng Mascara Festival. Ngayon, nakaraang ilang linggo ay dito sa pinakita ninyo sa buong Pilipinas at sa buong mundo na tayo dito sa Pilipinas ay nakabalik na, tayo ay handa na bumalik sa trabaho, tayo ay bumalik na sa eskwelahan ng mga ating mga kabataan, at tayo ay babalik na sa ating dating ginagawa na pagandahin at pataasin ang ekonomiya ng Pilipinas para maging mas mapinhawa ang buhay ng bawat Pilipino.
Aside from attending the Mascara Festival, Marcos also oversaw the Agriculture Department's aid distribution in Negros Occidental. Checks worth 88 million pesos were handed over to nearly 2,000 farmers in the country's top sugar-producing province.
Iba't ibang bansa ay nagkakaproblema, nadadala sa atin yung problema din. Kaya't kailangan natin mag-adjust, kailangan natin gumawa ng ibang paraan, at ito ay isa sa paraan na yun. And sa ngayon, tinitiyak lang natin na sapat ang dumadating sa taong bayan, hindi lamang asukal, pati na ang lahat ng produkto ng agrikultura, para naman ay kahit papaano ay masasabi natin ay may sapat naman na food supply na kayang bayaran ng ating mga mamamayan.
The Philippine Transportation Department gearing up for the expected influx of travelers for All Saints Day. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista says air, land, and sea travel units have all been expanded to accommodate the increase in number of passengers. Aside from ease travel restrictions, cemeteries across the Philippines will also reopen for this year's All Saints Day commemoration after being closed for the past 2 years due to the pandemic.
Yung ating airport, ready sila sa more flights, no? Yung ating mga bus companies, yung ating land transport, meron silang arrangement para magkaroon ng mas maraming buses and jeepneys, no? Yung mga ating mga barko, ready sila para isuporta yung pangangailangan ng ating mananakay para sa undas.
As for the prices of flowers, they are expected to go up this week, with demand seen to rise ahead of All Saints Day.